The moment three black teens mock a 56-year-old man and smile before beating him up for $10. The NYPD are now pleading for the public's help in identifying three young men wanted in connection with a brutal beating this week in Claremont Village. Police confirmed that a 56-year-old man was beaten merciless, mocked and robbed Tuesday around 2 a.m. The whole incident was caught on surveillance video. In the footage, three 17-year-old scumbags enter the lobby of a building on 169th Street and 3rd Avenue. They then proceed to approach the victim and instantly begin to punch and kick him repeatedly. The man attempted to defend himself by putting up his fists and preparing to fight off one of his attackers to no avail, as one of the other teens ran out of the lobby and returned with someone else so they could continue beating on the man. Officials say the suspects are all black and between 5 feet 6 inches and 5 feet 8 inches feet tall. Although the beatdown was ferocious, the victim is said to have refused medical attention when emergency responders arrived at the scene to treat his injuries. The suspects stole $10 from the victim's wallet before fleeing the scene. All this for $10. How nice would have all this ended if the man attacked would have been packing heat? Today we would have three fewer problems for our already overburdened society to have to deal with. 5 devastating facts about black-on-black crime. The mainstream American media is, again, happily hitting the Black Lives Matter crack pipe in its pernicious pursuit of high ratings. These bloodlusting junkies were nowhere to be found when, with haunting predictability, Chicago News headline after headline detailed the carnage that has consumed dozens of communities in that city where black men kill each other with terrifying regularity. Where were these Black Lives Matter protesters after the slaying of Chicago's little Tashawn Lee, the 9-year-old lured into an alley and shot to death by a black man seeking gang-related vengeance against his father? Did little Tashawn's murder at the hands of a black gangster, an all-too-common occurrence in Chicago, not warrant wall-to-wall news coverage or Al Sharpton and Jesse Jackson-style calls for justice? No. Why? Because the ugly truth behind #Black Lives Matter is that black people killing other black people does nothing to advance its political power in the same way that one white cop killing a black criminal can. Despite the media's overindulgence on white cops killing blacks, there is still a far larger amount of black bodies being sent to morgues by black killers. Here's 5 devastating facts, liberals can't deny, that prove it. Fact 1. Over 1,400 more black Americans murdered other blacks in 2 years than were lynched from 1882 to 1968. According to FBI data, 4,906 black people murdered other blacks in 2010 and 2011. That is 1,460 more black Americans killed by other blacks in 2 years than were lynched from 1882 to 1968, according to the Tuskegee Institute. Fact 2. Black people, mostly men, commit a grossly disproportionate amount of crime. In 2012, white males were 38% of the population and committed 4,582 murders. That same year, black males were just 6.6% of the population but committed a staggering 5,531 murders. In other words, black people at just a fifth of the size committed almost 1,000 more murders than their white counterparts. The figures above highlight a horrific truth that black racialists and white liberals routinely ignore: law-breaking black Americans, young black males particularly, put themselves in close proximity to, mostly white male, police officers at rates sometimes 5 to 10 times higher than whites. This is a recipe for disaster. Thusly. Fact 3. Despite making up just 13% of the population, blacks committed half of homicides in the United States for nearly 30 years. DOJ statistics show that between 1980 and 2008, black people committed 52% of homicides. In 2013, black criminals committed 38% of the murders. Whites accounted for just 31%. There are 5 times fewer black people than white people in America and, yet, they consistently carry out a larger share of the crimes? Given this rate, it's no wonder that there aren't more instances where cops kill black criminals. Fact 4. Chicago's death toll is almost equal to that of both wars in Iraq and Afghanistan, combined. There have been almost as many deaths in one American city as there have been in the two major wars carried out by the U.S. military this century. Chicago's death toll from 2001 November 26, 2015 stands at 7,401. The combined total deaths during Operation Iraqi Freedom, 2003-2015, 4,815, and Operation Enduring Freedom, Afghanistan, 2001-2015, 3,506, total 8,321. Fact 5. It would take cops 40 years to kill as many black men as have died at the hands of others black men in 2012 alone. University of Toledo criminologist Dr. Richard R. Johnson examined the latest crime data from the FBI's Supplementary Homicide Reports and Centers for Disease Control and found that an average of 4,472 black men were killed by other black men annually between January 1, 2009, and December 31, 2012. Professor Johnson's research further concluded that 112 black men died from both justified and unjustified police-involved killings annually during this same period. Isn't this the same old story? Why is it that although the black population is 13%, so many crimes are committed by blacks? Could it be maybe that the model of the welfare-dependent fatherless household doesn't work and ends up giving society criminals instead of upstanding and productive young men? Young men?